Hello guys, welcome back. Today we're going to be talking about your hair, skin, and nails, how to grow them, how to keep them healthy, and how to maintain them through food and not a supplement. So we're going to be addressing five major food sources for getting better results with your hair, skin, and nails so that you don't need to take supplements and you can achieve good results through your diet. And don't forget to like and subscribe if you like this content. Hold myself to a cord, waiting for the day that you come back to me. Okay, so usually when people want to grow their hair, skin, and nails, they go to those like easy little gummies or things that help with brittle nails and hair, like biotin supplements and stuff like that. So in my opinion, from what I've learned, biotin supplements are kind of unnecessary. The biotin that's there, you could easily get from your diet, and most of the times you are getting it from your diet anyways. So if your diet is nice and filled with nice, healthy, whole foods, then most likely you're already getting the amount of biotin that you need, and the supplements are just a waste of your money and they're not going to be absorbed. Biotin is also a water-soluble vitamin, so whatever you don't absorb and whatever your body says, oh, we have enough of, it'll just be excreted, so peed out. So that's where I think that biotin supplements are a waste of money and a waste of time. Like, why would you put extra supplements in your body when you can just get it from the food source? You want to be taking supplements that you maybe aren't getting from the food sources and that you need extra of, stuff like that. So that is my little tips and advice, and that's why I'm bringing this video to you guys, to show you guys food sources, like the real stuff you should be putting in your diet to help you with your hair, skin, and nails, rather than a supplement. Okay, so number one is gonna be carrots and sweet potatoes. So I'm gonna put those together in one category because they both have the same vitamin that I'm gonna be talking about, which is beta carotene, which converts into vitamin A within your body. So beta carotene is pretty much vitamin A. Beta carotene is really, really healthy for your tissues and your skin. It actually kind of sort of acts as like a natural sunblock, so it just helps protect your skin, keep it healthy, and keep it glowing. But don't get too much of it because vitamin A is fat soluble, so it stores in your body, and then too much can lead to toxicity, and it could be a little bit harsh on your liver. So just keep it light and just incorporate those orange fruits and vegetables, maybe not fruits, but the orange vegetables like carrots and sweet potato and maybe squashes and stuff like that to get that vitamin A, but not too much. Number two is strawberries. So strawberries have a vitamin C, and vitamin C is an antioxidant which helps with free radical damage and the formation of collagen. So collagen is needed all over for hair, skin, and nails in general. That's where you can see that collagen in maybe in a vitamin or a supplement, or you'll see it a lot of places as a really good sell for hair, skin, and nails and the benefits that it entails for hair, skin, and nails. But collagen forms within the body, and it can't just be rubbed on the skin. You can't just rub collagen on your skin and just expect collagen to grow. So that's where you want to form the collagen from within with sources like vitamin C. So vitamin C doesn't just come from strawberries. It comes from many different things, but strawberries have like a really potent amount of vitamin C. So that's why I mentioned that. Also, you can get vitamin C from obviously the citruses and from bell peppers and stuff like that. So it doesn't just stop at strawberries, but strawberries is a really nice little food source that is good for your hair, skin, and nails in that way. Next, we have Swiss chard. So Swiss chard has the biotin that we were just talking about that usually is in supplements, and this is going to be from an actual plant source, so you're getting it naturally. And biotin is linked with the brittleness. So lack of biotin is linked with like more brittleness in your nails. So brittle nails would usually be a sign of biotin deficiency. Rashes on the skin, stuff like that, are biotin deficiency symptoms. But to even that out, just get more food sources that have more biotin in them. There's tons of them. We're going to address some more in a couple minutes, but for now, Swiss chard has a lot of biotin, so there you go. And biotin is also known as vitamin B7, so if you see vitamin B7 on the back of something, you know that we're talking about biotin. So number four on our list is avocados. So avocados have two main nutrients there that we want to focus on, which is vitamin B and vitamin E. Vitamin B is for all the other things that can do, like for metabolism and for hair growth, so just kind of processing things into proteins and just building strong hair and nails and stuff like that. So that's with that. And now we have vitamin E. So vitamin E is a nice healthy fat. It's also a fat soluble vitamin. It's also an antioxidant, so it helps with free radical damage just like the vitamin C. But vitamin E is really good for repairing damage. Sometimes we get damage on the scalp that slows or prevents hair growth, and vitamin E helps to combat that damage. And in general, vitamin E is just really, really good for overall maintenance of the body and stuff like that. So avocados also have really good healthy fats in them as well, so that helps keep everything healthy and moisturized and nutrient dense in your body. So, and it's really easy to incorporate into your diet. You can throw it into a salad, you can put it in with anything, honestly, on like toast, whatever. Okay, so that brings us into number five. Number five is a really, really densely packed food source, which is beans. So beans have like protein, they have the zinc, they have biotin, they have basically just like, they're jam-packed with nutrients and everything that you would need for healthy systems. So those, the proteins help build up the proteins like that would be used, because basically your hair and nails are made of protein, so helps build those with those proteins from there. And then you got zinc, also helps with hair, skin, and nail maintenance. And then you have also the biotin. So again, biotin, low biotin is linked with nail brittleness and hair brittleness. When you're getting the biotin sources from the beans, you're increasing your biotin levels, which is then decreasing the potential for you having brittle nails and hair. But that's basically what we're trying to prevent. And all those food sources are really, really easy to get throughout your day. They're all vegan and they're all natural and blah, 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 blah. It's best to get your vitamins from the actual food itself. So just try your best to do that. You're gonna take away any chemicals or additives that you would have with the supplement, and you're just having the actual food source and getting the vitamins and minerals straight like that. So that is the best way to do that. And last, I'm just gonna go over those five food sources one more time to remind you. It's gonna be your carrots and sweet potatoes, so things that have the high vitamin A content. Strawberries, so things that have high vitamin C content. Swiss chard, things that have high biotin content. And then we have avocado, so things that are high in vitamin E. So also almonds are high in vitamin E as well. So it doesn't just stop with avocado, but again, that's just a good food source to include. And then the vitamin B that's in the avocado as well. And then lastly, we have the beans, which have the biotin, the proteins, and the zinc. Thank you guys for watching. That's about it. And I hope this encourages you guys to grow your hair, skin, and nails in a more natural way. Not that supplements are bad or that they're not natural, but just to avoid taking too many supplements, because I know we're in an age where everyone is just supplement every single thing. So just to remind you that you are completely able to get enough biotin in your diet alone, and you don't need to take a supplement for biotin. It's not really 100% necessary unless you notice that your body is having a troubled time in absorbing it and you have brittle nails, then I would look at it. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and leave any future questions that you have for a future, leave any questions that you have in the comments down below for a future Q&A. Like and subscribe, and I hope you guys have a beautiful day. I will see you guys next week. I'm in the process of growing my hair. I want to cut it. I need to cut off the split ends, but it's going good for me so far. Everything is pretty much growing well.
My eyelashes are doing well too.
I haven't had any issues, and I don't take biotin supplements, and all of my hair is growing fine, and my nails are doing fine. So yeah. And I'm done for today.